We contain magnitudes. Greetings, greetings, stargazers. I'm Trace Dominguez. The deep darkness of our sky is filled with incredible, colorful stars. This is the same tapestry looked at by ancient humans. And more than 2,000 years ago, the Greek astronomer Hipparchus was the first to start to categorize the stars by their brightness. He called this magnitude. The idea was to start a catalog of the stars we could see and give each a score, a magnitude. The brightest stars in the sky, you know, Sirius, Vega, Bellatrix, these were first magnitude stars. The next brightest stars were classified as second magnitude, and so on and so forth, all the way to the faintest stars getting a sixth magnitude classification. Of course, this was in 150 BCE. Hipparchus didn't have photography to help him get specific measurements. He only had his eyes. So in 1856, Norman Robert Pogson revised the magnitudes to be a ratio of brightness of 2.512. And each step up or down in M is 2.5 times dimmer or brighter than before. Because this is now based on a ratio instead of eyeballs, a magnitude difference of 5 is exactly 100 times brighter or dimmer in magnitude. So here is a magnitude line. Note again that it's backwards. Larger numbers are dimmer stars, which even professional astronomers sometimes mess up, so don't feel bad. But to do this, astronomers needed a baseline. They needed to base everything on something, so what did they choose? Vega. Vega is magnitude 0, and everything else is either dimmer or brighter than Vega. The naked eye can discern stars as faint as 6th magnitude. Anything more, and we will need binoculars or a telescope. Really bright things have negative magnitudes, like planets, the moon, and even the sun. If you leave your eyeballs out of it entirely, sensitive photography and telescopes can see things at 31 magnitudes and fainter. This is 10 billion times dimmer than what your naked eye can see. It's actually pretty incredible. So now, when you look up at a star, you can check its magnitude. And with practice, you'll know how bright to expect that star to be in the sky. Magnitude is a very valuable tool for astronomers in the attempt to taxonomize and categorize stars into groups. But it's also helpful for when you're looking at star guides. Now you can see one number and know if you're actually able to see that star in the sky while you keep looking up.